I have been involved in some kind of policy design or implementation related to work for the last 30 years, which is a horrible thing to say. I know I don't look it. the start of the New Deal programme. I've done two reports for the DWP on how you engage the most disadvantaged. I work for an organisation called Turning Point Health and Social Care. We provide, health and social care services in about 240 locations in England and Wales. We employ just over 4,000 people. Our turnover this year will be about £120 million, and we provide a service, either mental health, learned disabilities, substance misuse, primary care, to about one in 350 of the British public. That's one hat I wear. The other hat is I'm also a non-exec director of NHS England. I'm also a non-exec of a tech company, because I know sometimes when people come to speak to people like you, the question is, well, what gives them the right to say anything about anything? So my credentials are, I'm a board member of a startup. I get startups. It's a nightmare. You need the will of 10 people to get anywhere. You're fighting gravity all the time. I'm the chief exec of a large, not-for-dividend social enterprise, and I sit on the board of a government-sponsored agency called NHS England, and I'm a crossbench peer in the House of Lords. Don't hold that last one against me. Actually, I think the health and safety executive are on the edge of what I consider to be one of the biggest revolutions in the workplace. I say this as a qualified organisational psychologist, that my background is in organisational design, leadership, training and development, and that health and safety in work, in the workplace, is a question of leadership. And the statistics, and it's about mental health and emotional health, drives everything. One in four in London will have a mental health problem at any one time. I did a piece of work for the Metropolitan Police. I can tell you now that something like 25% of all police time is spent on mental health. We have some significant challenges around mental health. Many of you know the statistics around mental health in the workplace, but I always find it important to reflect on these figures. I think they speak volumes. 10 million employees in the UK, that's one in six affected by a mental health condition at any one time. 62,000 people a day. Stress-related illness accounts for the largest category of employee sickness, responsible for 91 million lost working days per annum, according to the Centre for Mental Health. Absence rates related to mental health conditions, included stress-related, continues to increase, with 15.2 million days lost in 2013. And I don't think it's about the lost days. We all know the connection between mental and physical health. We all know the impact that stress can have on the body, on the hormonal balance, on your ability to operate and function as a human being. Mental health, ill health, costs UK businesses almost £26 billion per annum. It's equal to £1,000 per employee per annum through sickness absence, staff turnover, and lost productivity. The Centre for Mental Health states that 20% of long-term absence caused by stress and family issues. So, what can we do to help both the employer and the employee? Turning Point runs IAP services throughout the country using a model called Right Steps, sometimes in partnership with local NHS providers, other times with private and public sectors. Recent research by the London School of Economics into IAP services found that on average depression scores of patients receiving treatment from a Right Step service can improve by, we say it's by 11.6%. Now, the percentage doesn't matter. The point I'm trying to make is there are services and interventions out there that work, that are widely available for people in the workplace, that will keep them healthy in work and will keep them able to deal with the normal interruptions to the smooth running of their mental health caused by depression and anxiety. Of those in work, those of you that are leaders, and I'm assuming that you're all leaders of yourselves, your relationships, your teams, your businesses, have a duty of care to those that you lead. It's a simple statement of fact, but one that we forget when we're under pressure as leaders. People prefer to be led, not driven. And if you're going to lead people, you have to understand your duty of care, and you have to understand those interventions which will most affect the ability to maintain a healthy state of mind and an effective, productive individual. And there are support services and support initiatives out there. Turning Point is part of a mission to bring mental health and mental well-being to the regular, normal activity of building effective cultures in workplaces. It's one of the reasons why I'm keen and work so hard, because it is hard work, as a member of NHS England. It's not just about talking about what the NHS can do for you, it's about what the NHS can do for its own employees. We cannot do it alone. Turning Point can't do it alone. You can't do it alone. It is something we have to do together. This is no longer a minority sport. There's no point in me just talking to the converted. I've assumed that you're here because you give a damn. That's the easy stuff. The people that we have to convince that this is important aren't in this room. And each one of you has to act as an ambassador for change. Not just in terms of, yeah, you've got a duty of care, but giving people the practical pointers of where they can go for help and assistance to stay healthy in work, to get back to work, and to maintain themselves and their families in a decent state. I could be changing what we think is important about being at work and staying in work. What's required is a partnership, and that partnership can start here and can start now, between us and the people outside this room, between the Health and Safety Executive and the NHS, between Turning Point and all of you. But I think we can do this. We're at the start of a journey which is going to change what work is, what it can do for not just the people in this room, but for the people outside it. Thank you very much.